Shavua Tov, a gute Woch, and welcome to our program. Shabbos morning we read the Parsha of Vo'eiro, and Shabbos to Mincha we started the Parsha of Bei. And Shabbos, Parshas Bei, next week is Yud Shvat. Yud Shvat is the Yovtzeit of the previous Rebbe and the beginning of the Nesiyas of this Rebbe. Moreover, this year, Toflish Pei Aleph, is 70 years from Yud Shvat Tovshin Yud Aleph, the formal day of the Nesiyas, when the Rebbe formally accepted the Nesiyas of Chabad and said the Maimel of Basi Legani. We find an interesting thing, and especially the timing of when the Rebbe spoke about it is of very, very great importance. The Rebbe spoke concerning Parshas Bei. The Rebbe spoke about the condition of the previous Rebbe. But he didn't speak in detail. He didn't say what the condition was. But he said that in the last years of his life in this world, his condition was similar to the condition of Moshe Rabbeinu. And by Moshe Rabbeinu it says, Ki kvat peh uchvat loshen onechi. I'm heavy-mouthed and heavy-tongued, said Moshe Rabbeinu. As a matter of fact, the Rebbe told the story that the doctor of the previous Rebbe, or to be exact, the professor, and the Rebbe said the professor is higher than a doctor, the professor had a question. He wanted to know how come the condition of the previous Rebbe is such. Not only that, and he explained his question, that his condition affects the power of speech, and he doesn't understand why this happened. Why? Because a Rebbe, in order for the Rebbe to function and to make sure that the Hasidim function, the Rebbe needs to say Hasidus. When the Rebbe says a Maimel, that Maimel is committed to writing, and then it is printed, and then it is sent all over the world for Hasidim to study it. This is how the entire movement then continues. I remember as a child in Paris, the Ma'amorim, the Kuntelisim from the previous Rebbe used to come in a Kuntelis. And I remember my father, always in his pocket was a Kuntelis of the Friedrich Rebbe. And they would learn it whenever they had a chance. Often tramvai, in metro, wherever they would go, they would learn the Kuntelis of the Friedrich Rebbe. Now, if there is a question with the speech, so there's a question about saying Ma'amorim, and if there's no Ma'amorim that the Rebbe said, there's no Ma'amorim to send out to Hasidim. In the Ma'amorim are not only Divrei Torah, in the Ma'amorim are Divrei Yisraelus, which means words of encouragement, also directives what to do and so on. And when there is a question about the Ma'amorim, because of the condition of the Rebbe, then everything does not get the proper exposure. That was the question of the previous of the doctor. Now, this makes the question in our parasha even stronger. In our parasha, Almighty God speaks to Moshe Rabbeinu, and he tells Moshe Rabbeinu that I have a mission. A mission, a shlichus, leich ve'ashlochacho el pari, that says before. But in our parasha, we are talking about when Almighty God says to him, be'el pari, go to pari and talk to him. Now, Moshe Rabbeinu, when Almighty God told him that he has a shlichus, leich ve'ashlochacho el pari, first he said about that he wants proof. And then Moshe Rabbeinu said, leish devorim olichi, I'm not a man of speech. I am heavy-mouthed and heavy-tongued. Rabbi say, there's a question. Moshe Rabbeinu cannot speak. Millions of people speak all the time. As the saying goes, people who have nothing to say talk all the time. And now with cell phones, forget about it. Wherever you go, you're on the train, you're on the bus, and you hear people talking loudly as they can, on a cell, disturbing everybody. I remember I was once going to the Eihel, not going to mention the name. It was out of Rosh Hashanah, in a small bus. And there was one fellow who was talking on a cell. Not only that, he couldn't hear that well. So if he couldn't hear that well, he couldn't hear what the person was saying. So he was talking very loudly. Now, everyone on the bus was disturbed. It's out of Rosh Hashanah. This one says a capital tilim. This one is preparing to write his poem. I'm not going to mention the name. And here's one person, he probably didn't think about it, because somebody was calling him and he had to do some business. And he didn't hear well. So he was talking Bekele Kelis. Everybody is talking. You go on the street and you see people motioning with their hands. Years ago, if you would see that, you would say, wait a minute, we got to figure out something. This person may be a little deranged. Today he's absolutely normal. He's talking on the phone in the middle of the street, and he's talking loudly. And not always does he care whether the neighbors or the people who are on the street care so much. But he talks. Whether he has something to say, doesn't have something to say, people talk all the time. One person whose talk is going to make the difference. Like these people talk, does it make a difference? They talk. Why not? The expression, talk is cheap, they talk all the time. But there's one person whose talk is going to make the difference. If Moshe Rabbeinu goes into Pali, and he says to Pali in no uncertain terms, Shalach esami, let my people go. That is going to make a difference. To 600,000 people, plus women and children, several million people will go out free. That individual, Moshe Rabbeinu says, I would like to do it, but I am heavy-tongued. The whole world can talk besides one person. How do you reconcile that? The Rebbe, in Parshas Bei, brings a medrash, or rather not a medrash, a zehal. And the Zehar says that the dibur of Moshe havo begoluso. The speech of Moshe was in Golus. Golus was so deep and so strong that the speech of Moshe was in Golus. And therefore, Moshe was a kvapeh, was heavy-mouthed. Because that's where the Golus hit. The Golus doesn't care that millions of people talk. Let them talk. It doesn't make any difference anyway. So let them talk. How do we say in Yiddish? Zon zirin. Doesn't make any difference. But the one man whose talk is going to make the difference, that's where the Golus hit. The Dibur of Moshe was in Golus. And what did the Rebbe say? And we'll soon talk when the Rebbe said that. The Rebbe said that the situation of the previous Rebbe was similar to that of Moshe Rabbeinu. And by Moshe Rabbeinu it says, Ki kvat peh uchvat loshen onichi, I'm heavy mouth and heavy tongued. And we will see what kind of ramifications this had in our generation. But first, our customary story, or stories. Chof Ches Tevis, just now, was the birthday of Rebbe Tzinchana. I remember being with our family by Rebbe Tzinchana many times, and she said, this I heard several times, she said, Ich bin nicht nur Abbas Talmid Chochem, ich bin Eich Aneshes Chovel, which is a gemara. She's not only the daughter of a Talmid Chochem, the Meir Shleime was a big Talmid Chochem, but she's also a Neshes Chovel, the wife of a Chovel, the wife of a Talmid Chochem. And she said that repeatedly, several times. I remember a personal story. She once called me, and she asked for a favor. And she had a pair of black high shoes, boots, if you want to call it. And they were of leather, of suede, of black suede. The problem was that the inner bones, as a person gets elderly, sometimes the bone perturbs a little bit. And therefore, it was giving her pain. And she gave me the boots, the high shoes, and she showed me where the problem is. And she said, see what you can do to fix them. I took the shoes, the boots. I brought them to a shoemaker who was at that time on Albany Avenue between Union and President, closer to Union. That building doesn't stand anymore. And there was a shoe store there. And I told him that this is for a very important person. And I told him what he should do, that he should make a round hole, and then he should get a piece of black suede, that's suede on the outside and fur on the inside, and then he should put it in, he should patch it in. He listened, Baruch Hashem, and he did, I must tell you, a very, very nice job. And I came back, and I gave it to the Levitson. She said, ein Minute. She went into the other room. She put them on. And she came back. She was smiling. And she said, Zeir git, Zeir bakvim. Very good, very comfortable. I thank God that I had that schutz. Rebbe Zanchana told a story about her husband, the believer Yitzchok, that in the difficult times when he was in jail, there was no water to drink. But the believer Yitzchok was not worried for the water to drink. He was worried for the water from the Tilas Yodayim. And somehow, miraculously, they brought him a cup of water, which is not even a question that you should use that cup to drink. It's pikuach nefesh. How long can a person last without water? But the believer Yitzchok chose to use that cup of water for Netilas Yadayim. Heard the story from the Rebbe Tzanchana. Rebbe Tzanchana also told the story that during the time of their Shidduch, she said, Hab ich gewollt es al trog na schlappe. It seems it was after the Shidduch, before the wedding. That's how it seems. She wanted he should wear a schlappe. That's what she said, a schlappe. That's a hat the way we wear. As a matter of fact, the Rebbe also called it a schlappe. You hear it in the recordings of Tovshin Lamed Ches. The Rebbe asked, Wo die schlappe? And he was wearing a casket. And the Rebbetzin wanted he should wear a schlappe. And he didn't want. So it took a little negotiations. And then she said, with a half smile, and ich hab euch gefehlt. And it was the way I wanted. He wore a schlappe. It's known also by Chassidim, it's not a contradiction to the story that Rebbe Tzanchana said, that he asked the Rebbe Nishma Seiden what to do. It seems it took a little time, a while, and the Rebbe Nishma Seiden told her that he should listen to what the Rebbe Tzanchana wants. The Rebbe Tzanchana also told the story that it was the last year where the Rebbe and the believer Yitzchok were together on Simchas Torah. And it was very painful. She says, the father knew that this is their last Simchas Torah together. And the son knew that this is the last Simchas Torah together. But the father wouldn't let it be known to the son, and the son didn't let it be known to the father. And they both pretended like, it's not there, we're together. And minat getanzt und getanzt und getanzt. They danced and they danced and they danced. This was what the Rebbe Tzanchana said, the last Simchas Torah where the believer Yitzchak and his son, the Rebbe and his father, the believer Yitzchak, were together. Going back to the Sicha. Now there is a question. The whole world can talk, but Moshe Rabbeinu can't talk. So the Midrash says, the Zayar says, the Dibur was in Golus. The Dibur of Moshe Rabbeinu was in Golus because that would make the difference. Now, concerning the previous Rebbe, the Rebbe says that we mentioned before that the professor asked a question, how come his condition touched the power of speech? Now, if we pay attention, and we do, the Baba Shechassidim, when did the Rebbe say that? When did the Rebbe speak about the condition of the previous Rebbe? Now we're talking about Yud Shvat of Shin Yud Aleph. Arguably, the Rebbe should have spoken then, or could have spoken then, about the condition of the previous Rebbe, how difficult it was for him the last few years. The Rebbe never mentioned it. Not only that, the Rebbe never mentioned all the years, not only Yud Aleph and Chof Aleph and Lamed Aleph and Mem Aleph, all the years, and not Tov Shin Nun, and not Tov Shin Nun Aleph. The Rebbe mentioned it once. Before Yud Shvat, Tov Shin Nun Beis, the last stop, just a few weeks before Chof Zayin Od Rishin, Tov Shin Nun Beis. That's when the Rebbe mentioned it. The Rebbe never mentioned it before. With a little bit of a poetic license, maybe the reason is that the Rebbe was not only talking about the condition of the previous Rebbe. The Rebbe chose this time, now and only now, Tov Shin Nun Beis, a few weeks before Chof Zayin Od Rishin Tov Shin Nun Beis, to tell us something, because he's not only talking about the previous Rebbe, he's also talking about himself. That the condition is going to the time soon, unfortunately, happened then. And it's the same thing. That hand, the hand of the Rebbe, that hand was affected. That hand of the Rebbe, that right hand, that right hand of the Rebbe that gave out Keshel Brocho to tens and tens of thousands of people. That right hand that gave dollars to tens of thousands of people. That hand that said L'chaim. That hand when the Rebbe went with his hand, the Rebbe lifted up the spirit of everyone in sight. That hand was affected. How do you reconcile that? Millions of people have hands and feet, and their deeds don't really make much of a difference. Or whatever they do, don't make. Here's one man, the leader of the generation, whose hand would make the difference. That when whatever would motion with his hand, with his right hand, he would lift up the spirit of everyone, of the entire world. That hand was affected. Talking about a mouth. There's so many people who use the mouth, who knows for what. Rahman al-Islam, even for things that I love, dafke mutter. It's the Rebbe's mouth. It's with that mouth that the Rebbe said mamorim, the mouth that the Rebbe said sichas, the mouth that the Rebbe gave brochis, directives, the mouth with which the Rebbe led the world. The same condition as the condition of Moshe Rabbeinu. How do you reconcile that? So when the Rebbe is talking about the condition of the previous Rebbe, and the Rebbe chose to talk about it not Tov Shin Yud Aleph, and not Tov Shin Nun Aleph, Tov Shin Nun Beis, and when Tov Shin Nun Beis, before Yud Shvat Tov Shin Nun Beis, which is just a few short weeks before Chof Zayin Od Rishin Tov Shin Nun Beis. So there is a message that the Rebbe is not talking about only about the previous Rebbe. Maybe there is a message to us. The Rebbe is also talking about himself. And what did the Rebbe say about the previous Rebbe? The Rebbe didn't say it in order to put us in a bad mood. The Rebbe didn't like a morbid mood. The Rebbe didn't like tears. The Rebbe liked simcha, to be uplifted. And the Rebbe says that, what is the answer? What is the answer to the condition of the previous Rebbe? What does it mean to us? And the Rebbe says, as how do we rectify that condition? That is, that's bekeche fun dem bal hayelula. It's all with the spirit and the power of the previous Rebbe. But with the spirit of the power of the previous Rebbe, we are here in this world. And we, Baruch Hashem, we have hands and we have a mouth. So therefore, we should do the same thing as Aaron did. Aaron was the mouth of Moshe Rabbeinu. And what we can do, we can be, so to speak, the mouth of the previous Rebbe. What was difficult then, we can make up. If we use our mouth to learn, and we use our mouth to daven, if we use our mouth to say to a Jew, Shalom Aleichem, Vos machstu, how are you, how do you feel, how are things with you? And today, basically in this day and age, we have almost strangers calling and say, how are you? And when you tell them, Baruch Hashem, Baruch Hashem, Baruch Hashem, we're here. So to call a Jew and to ask him, tell me how you are, how you're managing in this situation, and give him encouragement. I once heard a quote, Ishes re'ehu ya'azeru ule'ochiv ye'mal chazok. One would help a friend, you would help a friend, and to a brother you would say, be strong. There's almost a redundancy here. Ishes re'ehu ya'azeru means you help, ule'ochiv ye'mal chazok means you say to your brother, be strong. And also a form of being, of helping. And the answer is, and you don't need a poetic license for this. Sometimes you can help somebody. He's in trouble. You can give him a loan. You can give him a netzah. You can give him an apartment. What if you do not have a netzah for him? And you're not in a condition to give him a loan. And you're not in a condition to give him an apartment. And you're not in a condition to find a son or child. However, you can go over to him and look him deep into the eyes and say, brother, be strong. Give him the strength. Give him encouragement. If you can give him nothing else. If you can help him, zavadagut, absolutely. But even you only use your mouth. Somebody called me not long ago and he said, I want to give you a blessing. Okay. And then he says, I'm going to give you a blessing of a friend. And it says all over, a blessing of a friend works because he means it. And that we can do. That we can use our mouth, the mouth that the Almighty God gave us. And the Rebbe says, and we should do it in a way of neshames b'riyas beguf b'riyim. Neshames b'riyas begufim b'riyim. Which means healthy neshames within healthy bodies in this world. We are in this world, and Baruch Hashem, Almighty God, gave us a mouth, and Baruch Hashem, we have a mouth. Everybody has a mouth. If you don't believe me, just go down the street, and you will see how many people are talking on the phone. So Baruch Hashem, we have a mouth. Says the Rebbe, we use the mouth that God gave us, and the ability to speak that we have, to speak good things. Chas v'sholem, not loshen hara, of course, but good things. Good things about each other, learning, davening, everything we do with our mouth. And when we're talking about hands, about deeds, good deeds. Almighty gave us hands and we can move our hand. Baruch Hashem. So therefore we should use that power of movement, that ability to do and to walk and to help. To help each other, to help Botei Chabad, to help Almighty God, and to help the Rebbe making an end, Emel Falalamol, once and for all, to this Golus. So with this, we can maybe understand why the Rebbe said it concerning the Friedrich Rebbe that the Rebbe was talking about himself. And it's important for us for this generation coming to Yud-Shvat. The Rebbe Yud-Shvat said clearly what his quote-unquote administration is going to accomplish. The Rebbe said that there is a minhag in America that when there is a new president, he makes a statement, a declaration as to what he is going to accomplish. Azil lekalto, avid kinimuso, say our sages. When you go to a town, you do as the customs of the town are. So the Rebbe says he's going to do the same thing as when there is a new president and he makes a new declaration. And what is his declaration? His declaration is that he will bring Mashiach Tzidkenu bepeil mamash. Yes, we've been talking about Mashiach for generations, but we want Mashiach bepeil mamash, the Geula Amitis v'Hashleimo bepeil mamash. And that's what the Rebbe is doing. So we still need to put those finishing touches, emol falalamol, on the golus. And Emir Tashem will go out together, as the Rebbe promises us so many times, that we are the last generation of golus and the first generation of Geula, and that our generation will be that generation that will see the Geula Hamitis v'Yashlema with our very, very own eyes. Uva'agolo didan uva'simcho uv'tuv leivov uva'teva nile ve'aniglo lamato me'asolot fochim uva'chesed uva'lachamim and take umiyad mamesh.